Hi, I'm Dr. Jeff McCombs. I'd like to welcome you to our webcast today. And briefly, it's going to be the science behind Candida. It's quite an endeavor we're attempting here. We have a lot of information we want to get out to people, and I don't think we realize the magnitude of what that would entail for us. So if you'll bear with us as we kind of go through this process, we'll try to give you as much information as possible and hope that you can benefit by that. One of the nice things, we'll be showing some slides, some videos, some pictures, and you'll be able to go back over those and review those in the future. And so if you don't catch it now, you can go back and you'll be able to go to our website, McCombsPlan.com, and play those over and over again and really get a better look at what we're talking about along with the video and audio. Again, I'm Dr. Jeff McCombs. I'm the founder of the McCombs Plan for Health, Vitality, and Transformation. The website again is www.McCombsPlan.com. I'm a third generation doctor of chiropractic, and I've been practicing now for almost 26 years. Basically, one of the things I really emphasize in my patients is the treatment of Candida, and that tends to be my specialty these days. The science behind Candida is the title of our show today, and we're going to be interacting. Lisa's behind the camera here and on the computer with Hugo taking calls and also on the computer. And I know you just held up something which I didn't see, so okay. Basically, I want to start off, when we talk about Candida, it's good to have a definition of Candida, and it's also good to have an understanding of the human body. That in itself is pretty much impossible, as much as we can attempt it. There's a lot we know about the human body, but as I tell most of my patients and most people I talk to, we know probably about 1% of what goes on in the body. And that's why everything's such a mystery. And that's why some things work, some things don't. That's why we have such little understanding. That's one of the main reasons why drugs don't work, because they don't really know what's taking place in the body once you give somebody a drug, and therefore you have all these side effects. They don't know really why we have those side effects. But in terms of Candida, what we're doing is we're talking about an organism which lives inside the intestinal tract, or commonly referred to as the gut. The intestinal tract in humans contains really the small intestine, is made up of the small intestine and large intestine. The length of that intestinal tract is approximately 28 feet, 25 to 28 feet in most people. The intestinal tract has a vast surface area inside, which allows it to absorb a lot of nutrients. They have what are called villi, which are little finger-like projections, and this increases the surface area of the intestinal tract to be approximately 200 square meters, or roughly the size of a tennis court, which is the common analogy for that amount of area. Within this 25 to 28 foot length tract, we have 100 trillion cells. Well, that's a number that most people really can't relate to. But a good way to relate to it is that the human body has 10 trillion cells. So there are actually 10 times more microorganisms that live within this 25 to 28 foot tract than there are in the rest of the body. Human cells are much larger than the microorganisms, than the bacteria, the fungus, the yeast, the mold, the virus, the parasites, which make up all these microorganisms that live in the gut. Now, all of these microorganisms over years have co-evolved. This usually happens right at birth. They have co-evolved to exist together. So many times we hear people talk about beneficial bacteria, bad bacteria. When we think of a healthy intestinal tract, it's really tends to be all good. They're all working together in concert. There's a strong immune system, which helps to regulate and keep everything in check. 70% of the immune system of the body is in the digestive tract. So if we have an imbalance here, that is most of the immune system of the body. So we have to really consider what happens in the gut as the way the rest of the health of the body will go. And much of what happens in the gut, as far as all these bacteria and microorganisms, helps to develop our immune system and helps to prime the immune system. And science shows us that even as immune cells are being produced in distant sites, such as the bone marrow, it is what happens in the gut which helps to determine how these cells are produced, how they will function later on in their life, short as it is. So we have 100 trillion cells, and what we're focusing on are really bacteria and candida, but everything together. The human gut has been called the densest ecosystem on the planet. And much of the advances in science are based on technology that we were using in dense ecosystems like the Amazon jungle and other rainforest habitats. We found that if we took that technology and applied it to the gut, we were able to find out more and more about the gut and about the microorganisms that live there. And there are even more new advances that are taking place in nanotechnology, which are going to allow us to see what exactly is happening inside the cells. And a good point here is we don't know exactly what is happening inside the cells. So we're back to this piece of information I give to people. We know about 1% of what's going on. But based on that 1%, at least in the holistic community, we know that the best way to approach healing in the body is to support the body in doing what it does, to bring balance back to the body and let the body do what it can do best, and not try to interpret through science, such poor science as it is, to try and understand how we can destroy bacteria, how we can destroy fungus through antifungal drugs, antibacterial drugs, antibiotics. So if we look again at all these microorganisms, they're called commensals. And basically the best way to describe commensals is harmless. So candida in its normal state is a harmless microorganism, as are most of the other organisms in the gut. E. coli is a bacterial organism that many people are familiar with through a lot of news reports of E. coli infected spinach, beef, etc., causing disease and illness in people. Well, E. coli as a commensal, as a harmless bacteria in the gut, is part of all these other 100 trillion organisms, and it plays a role. It helps in the synthesis of vitamin K, which we need for normal blood clotting. And it's when we change that internal environment that we run into problems. So candida as an organism usually exists as a commensal as a yeast organism. And the yeast organism has the ability to change its form or morph, and it's considered to be a polymorphic organism. It can change from a yeast to a pseudo-hyphal form or pseudo-fungal form, and then to a mycelial hyphal form, which is the fungal form. And it's that ability to change which creates the problem. Very similar to E. coli, it can change from its harmless form to a pathogenic, harmful form. And what we really look at is what can create that. Well, we've already talked about the immune system. 70% of the immune system is in the gut. So anything that would suppress the immune system can have an effect on the growth of candida. And one of the things that commonly affects the immune system are going to be drugs, antibiotics. The chemicals in the environment. If we look at the body burden survey that was done a few years ago, the umbilical cord of babies that was tested had 287 chemicals. If you look at the 287 chemicals that babies were being born with, most of these induce cancer, immunosuppressive actions in the body, all kinds of diseases and other conditions. So as an adult, as we've lived longer in life, we've accumulated more. And of the 287 toxins, they were testing around 480. So over half of what they tested show up. And there are over 100,000 different chemicals in the environment. We don't have the capacity yet to test for those. But there is new science, which is actually old scientific techniques called high throughput screening, which will allow us to test large amounts of chemicals now here in the near future, which is something that's being begun. So we'll start to really understand how many chemicals the human body holds. So we have chemicals which are already in us having an effect, an accumulative effect. And then we introduce drugs which can have a very devastating effect. And one of the things I really look at continually with candida is the use of antibiotics. Antibiotics, by far, will induce systemic fungal infections more so than any other drug. Steroids are another one. And we'll look at some science here that shows that. And this is where it may get a little dry and boring. But what I want to do is actually read to you some of the information that's in the science. And all of these articles that I'll read from will be in our Candida library, and many of them are already put in the library, and we're continually loading hundreds of others. And we hope to get this live as soon as possible. Some of the videos and pictures we'll be showing you today, the slides, are also in the library. So we'll have a gallery of pictures and videos you can go to and look at this, and you look at the information. Right now the information is all there, but it's not connected. And so today I'm hoping to